Now, joining me now is Christopher Busby, the Scientific Secretary at the European Committee on Radiation Risk. Thank you, sir, for joining us this evening here. We really appreciate your expertise on this one. Now, how crucial is this situation? Can you explain it to us?
Well, the main problem is that some of the materials that were contaminating that area are extremely volatile, and they will have been incorporated into the wood. So, in other words, they land on the ground in 1986, and they get absorbed into the trees and into all of the biosphere there. And so, when it burns, they just become resuspended. So it's like Chernobyl all over again, if you like. So all of that material that fell on the ground will now be burned up into the air, and will become available for people to breathe in the direction that the flames are going and that the airflow is going. The other problem, of course, is that internal radiation from inhalation, so in other words, if you inhale something radioactive and it gets inside you, it's very much more dangerous than just the background radiation that comes off the ground. So it's really quite an important situation. It's something that really needs to be brought under control as quickly as possible. And it certainly shows the dangers of investing in nuclear power where there is this possibility of accidents and these substances can get out into the environment.
Well, that's what I was going to ask you about the environment, about people taking in this air, because how worried should we be about residential areas? How worried should the people be who live near?
People should stay inside. I mean, it's extremely serious, so they should not go outside and inhale the air. Because the point is that this stuff will remain volatilized, it will remain airborne, and in particular there will be particles that can be inhaled. And if you stay inside, then eventually these particles will either blow away or they will go back onto the ground again, and you will be safe. But people should...
How long do you imagine that they would have to stay inside before the particles would be clean?
Oh, I think probably it would be a question of it would depend on where you are. If you're talking about the area, then it would be like, I suppose, weeks. But if you're talking about far away, then of course these particles could travel great distances. I mean, after Chernobyl itself, they ended up in the atmosphere and they went right across the Baltic states and into Finland and over Sweden and down into the United Kingdom, where they caused significant increases in cancer. So this is a very serious matter if these substances do become volatilized as a result of the intense heat that these forest fires produce, which they almost certainly will.
And do you think that the emergency services, do you think that they're going to be able, are they capable of dealing with the situation? Because a lot of pressure is presumably on them right now.
I think all the emergency services are trying to put the fire out. I mean, once this stuff is up in the air, once the actual trees that contain the cesium and the strontium and the other elements that have been absorbed into the wood, once those burn, then that stuff goes into the atmosphere. There's nothing you can do about that. And so all they can do now is to try and put this fire out. And I certainly hope that the Ukrainian authorities have the technical competence to do that. Otherwise, it could be, and I'm not saying it is, it depends upon the extent of the forest fire and how far it goes and so forth. But at the moment, it does seem as if it is quite a critical problem, quite a serious health hazard.